Hello, I'm Simon Whistler. You're watching Today I Found Out, and in the video today, we're looking at why snakes and many other animals don't get sunburned. Without a protective coating of feathers, fur, or scales, pretty much any animal with exposed skin can get sunburn. Luckily, most animals have adapted methods of avoiding the sun and mitigating the damage. Farmers have long known that naked animals, like freshly shorn sheep and domesticated pigs, who've had their thick coating of back hair bred out of them, can get a sunburn. In fact, although uncommon, even light-furred and hairless dogs and cats have been known to burn. Likewise, naturalists have observed burns from ultraviolet radiation on elephants and rhinoceroses, and in fact, even whales, fish, amphibians, and dolphins occasionally get a burn from the sun. In research published in the Proceedings of the Royal Society in 2010, the scientists reported that certain whale species, notably the relatively light-skinned blue whale, not only would suffer from sunburn, but that the rate of sunburn in marine mammals was increasing over time. The researchers hypothesized that ozone layer loss and thinning cloud cover could potentially be to blame for the increase. Those same scientists also found that even though sperm whales spend significantly more time on the surface in between dives, 7 to 10 minutes, when compared with blue whales, about 2 minutes, the darker sperm whales were far less likely to suffer from sunburn. Further research revealed that the sperm whale's skin had a protective protein that inhibits UV cellular damage. Notably, although the blue whale's incidences of sunburns were increasing, the scientists did find evidence that the species is able to tan, so sun exposure did not always result in such damage. Likewise, many land animals have also adapted methods of protecting themselves from the sun. For example, pigs and rhinoceroses wallow in mud, as do elephants, who are also known to seek out shade, toss dirt and sand on their backs, and create protective shadows for their little ones. Hippos secrete an oily pinkish-red liquid, particularly around their ears and faces, the only parts typically above the water's surface for any length of time, and that absorbs ultraviolet light and is also, apparently, an antibiotic. As for snakes and other reptiles that bask in the sun, their inner epidermis is protected from UV rays via their scales, which also function to help retain moisture. For these animals, they would typically die from overheating before any threat of sunburn became a problem. And now for a bonus fact. A review published in JAMA Dermatology in January of 2014 showed that exposure to the UV wavelengths associated with indoor tanning beds accounts for nearly twice as many skin cancer diagnoses as smoking does for lung cancer. This study was focused on the US and showed 400,000 cases annually for tanning beds compared to 200,000 from smoking. Further, even just one tanning bed session increases your risk of melanoma, the deadliest form of skin cancer, by 75%. This is why the American Medical Association, the American Academy of Pediatrics, the American Academy of Dermatology, the Skin Cancer Foundation, and the World Health Organization have all called on every state to ban children under 18 from using tanning salons. So I really hope you found that video informative and interesting. If you did, please do hit that thumbs up button below. And don't forget to subscribe, brand new videos every day of the week. I'd also like to take this moment to thank our patrons on Patreon. If you're interested in supporting us with a small and voluntary financial contribution, please head over to patreon.com/todayIFoundOut. And as always, thank you for watching.